Before the birth of light, there was darkness. And from that darkness came the dark elves. Millennia ago, the most ruthless of their kind, Malekith, sought to transform our universe back into one of eternal night. Such evil was possible through the power of the ether, an ancient force of infinite destruction.
Sell toys?
We sell forbidden objects from places men fear to tread. We also sell frozen yogurt, which I call Frogurt.
Now that I've covered the school and gone over the spells associated with it and the classes that can utilize it, I thought I would see what necromancy-related items I could dig up for you. That's not to say that the following items can only be used by necromancers or are only beneficial to necromancers, but they are on brand, if you take my meaning. Let's start with rods. There's one rod that I think would complement your necromantic doings, the Rod of Withering. The Rod of Withering will cost you 25k gold. It acts as a +1 light mace, but it does no hit point damage. Instead, the Rod of Withering deals 1d4 points of strength damage and 1d4 points of constitution damage to any creature it touches. A DC 17 fort save negates. Next up, we have some lovely staves. Now, I have yet to do an item guide related to staves, but that's coming in the future. Just be aware that your staff has a maximum of 10 charges. The first staff I'm going to recommend is the Staff of Curses. This staff can be used to cast Blindness or Deafness. That takes one charge. Ill Omen, also one charge. Baleful Polymorph, 2 charges. And of course, Bestow Curse, 2 charges. In addition, the staff can be used as a +1/+1 quarterstaff. And if you strike a creature with the staff, you can expend 1 charge to curse the creature for a number of rounds equal to the remaining charges in the staff. A Staff of Curses will cost 43,500 gold. Next up, how could I possibly not talk about the Staff of Necromancy? A Staff of Necromancy can be used to cast Cause Fear, 1 charge, Ghoul Touch, 1 charge, Halt Undead, 1 charge, Enervation, 2 charges, Waves of Fatigue, 2 charges, Circle of Death, 3 charges. A Staff of Necromancy, if you go out and buy it, will cost 82,000 gold, so kind of a pricey item. Then there's the Staff of Dark Flame. This acts as a +1 flaming quarterstaff, but only one end has the flaming quality. A Staff of Dark Flame can be used to cast False Life, 1 charge, Ray of Enfeeblement, 1 charge, Scorching Ray, 1 charge, Fireball, 2 charges, and Animate Dead, 3 charges. A Staff of Dark Flame will cost you 47,000 gold. Finally, this is the staff that I really like, the Staff of Hungry Shadows. The Staff of Hungry Shadows can be used to cast Darkness, 1 charge, Ray of Enfeeblement, 1 charge, Vampiric Touch, 1 charge, Enervation, 2 charges, Summon Shadow, as Summon Monster 5, but summons 1 shadow, 2 charges, and, by far my favorite ability, Call Devourer. This functions as Planar Binding, but it calls 1 Devourer, and that will cost you 3 charges. If you're unaware, a Devourer is a super scary extra-planar undead that eats souls, hence the name. So, while all the other necromancers are just raising any random dead jerko they can find, you're going to be saying, hey, look at my scary buddy from the undead dimension, and you can just wave that in their face. Or you'll be able to, if you can pony up 69,300 gold pieces. Moving on to rings, I could only really find one ring that worked as a necromancy-themed item, but you're really going to have much better options. That is the Spiritualist Rings. They're expensive at 70,000 gold. With it, you can cast Speak with Dead 3 times per day. You can cast Spectral Hand. You can give your weapon Ghost Touch. Or you get a +4 sacred or profane bonus on saving throws against positive or negative energy. I don't really think these are worth it, but if you happen to find them as a loot item, they're pretty neat. And they let you talk to dead people, so why not? Moving on to the next worn item, your belt. You have a lot of really good options when it comes to belts, just in general. But if you have the money or the luck of finding a Shadowform belt, I think it really works great. This belt gives you a whopping +6 enhancement bonus to your dexterity. And you can, as a swift action, become incorporeal. For up to 10 rounds per day, these rounds do not need to be consecutive. The Shadowform belt is extremely expensive at 110,000 gold. Now onto the body category. First off, I don't think you can go wrong with the good old-fashioned Robe of Bones. This robe essentially allows you to create some really cheap little dead-o minions for yourself, with no muss and no fuss. It's also relatively cheap to buy, at 2,400 gold. With your Robe of Bones, you can make things like human skeletons, wolf skeletons, heavy horse skeletons, and a plague ogre zombie. Now, if you happen to be a skilled crafter or very well financed, you might think about picking up Robes of the Archmage. I do need to warn you about these. They come in 3 colors, black, white, and gray, corresponding with your moral alignment. If you put on the wrong robe, you're going to be enjoying 2 negative levels until you take them off. But if they happen to be the right alignment for you, you'll enjoy a +5 armor bonus to AC, spell resistance 18, +4 on all saving throws, and a +2 enhancement bonus on caster level checks made to overcome spell resistance. Robes of the Archmage will cost 75,000 gold. Now on to your chest slot. My first recommendation will be a Spectral Shroud. This allows you to discern ethereal or invisible creatures, as though using See Invisibility, and once per day you can become incorporeal for 10 rounds and gain flying equal to half your base speed. A Spectral Shroud costs 26,000 gold. Then there's always the Tunic of Careful Casting. This comes in at a modest 5,000 gold, and it gives you a +2 bonus on concentration checks. Moving into the Eyes category, I really don't have anything good for you. Sorry. Under the Feet category, how could I not recommend Haunted Shoes? Haunted Shoes allow you to, twice per day, call forth 1d4 unseen servants. They last for 3 hours. And once per day, you can command the spirits inside the shoes to surround you with kind of an aura thing that gives you a 20% mischance for 3 minutes. Haunted Shoes will cost you 6,480 gold. Moving on to the hand slot for your necromantic needs, I would recommend Vampiric Gloves. Vampiric Gloves allow you to 3 times per day cast Vampiric Touch and Bleed. In addition, you can use Vampiric Touch as a ranged touch ability out to 30 feet, but only against a dying target or a target suffering from bleed. Vampiric Gloves will cost you 18,000 gold. For your head slot, I really don't have any good head necromancy themed items for you, so I'm just going to move on. In the headband department, you have a lot of really good options, and I don't know if I entirely recommend either of these headbands for really well-optimized characters, but they're interesting options. First off, there's the Headband of Knucklebones. This allows the wearer to use Command Undead up to 3 times a day, and it allows you to, once a day, animate 1 medium zombie as if using the Animate Dead spell. The price on a Headband of Knucklebones is 27,500 gold. Now then, if you happen to be a necromantic divine caster, I would recommend the Phylactery of Negative Channeling. This increases the damage dealt and damage healed from your negative energy by 2d6. A Phylactery of Negative Energy Channeling will cost 11,000 gold. I was not able to find anything particularly interesting for you in the next slot, but that's another one that has a plethora of good options for your character, just in general. So let's move on to the shoulders. A nice thematic shoulder item is the Cloak of the Duskwalker. This grants you low light vision, and once per day on command, you can shroud yourself with darkness as the darkness spell. While in this darkness, you get dark vision out to 60 feet as well as your low light vision. A Cloak of the Duskwalker will cost you 10,000 gold. Now, if you happen to be theming your necromancer more around decomposition, you might want to think about picking up a Mantle of Spores. This grants you a +4 resistance bonus against disease. And once per day, you can, as a swift action, surround yourself with a cloud of deadly spores. Creatures adjacent to you take 1d6 points of damage from the spores, plus 1d3 points of damage per round for 3 rounds. A Mantle of Spores will cost you 13,400 gold. Now onto the wrist slot. The only thing I can really recommend for you, and this definitely isn't necromancer specific, this is just caster specific, are Spellguard Bracers. This grants you a +2 bonus on concentration checks made to cast defensively, and 3 times per day, the wearer can choose to reroll concentration checks to cast defensively and take the better result. Spellguard Bracers are fairly inexpensive at 5,000 gold pieces. Now on to the slotless wondrous items. First off, there's the Bone Razor. This is a nasty little item. It seems to function as a dagger, and if you use it in a coup de grace against a helpless living creature, and that creature dies from the attack, it becomes either a zombie or a skeleton under your control. A Bone Razor is fairly cheap at 5,000 gold pieces. Next up, we have a fantastic little item called Bottle of Shadows. A Bottle of Shadows has 4 charges. Each charge allows you to summon one shadow to do whatever it is you want. If the shadow kills a humanoid creature with at least 4 HD, the bottle gets 1 charge back, and the bottle automatically refills at sundown. A Bottle of Shadows will cost you 7,000 gold pieces. Next, we have the Cauldron of the Dead. This item really just allows anyone to use Animate Dead, and you can only make zombies with it, which isn't very good. I think skeletons are the superior choice. And it'll cost you the same amount of gold. If you don't have the Animate Dead spell, you can control up to 12 HD worth of undead. And if you do have the Animate Dead spell, it just counts against the limit of undead that you can control. But come on, it's the Black Cauldron. Who doesn't want the Black Cauldron? If you want a Black Cauldron of your very own, it will cost you 30,000 gold. Next on my recommendation list is the Eye of the Void. An Eye of the Void looks like a normal little black crystal ball until it opens and reveals it's a scary Cthulhu eyeball. It gets 2 gaze attacks. The first in a 30-foot cone and the second in a 15-foot sphere. Each creature subject to the gaze must make a DC 16 will save. If they succeed, they're shaken for 1 minute, but if they fail, they're frightened for 1 minute, and they take 1d6 points of wisdom damage. This is a mind fear effect. An Eye of the Void will cost you 10,000 gold pieces, and maybe just a little bit of sanity. Next, there's the Grim Lantern. This is another one of those items that isn't that great, but it is kinda cool. It's an eerie skull lantern with some stuff called soul stuff inside that you can ignite and have it shoot a cone of flames as the Burning Hands spell. Doing this extinguishes the lantern. However, when a living creature with at least 1 HD is slain within 30 feet of the lantern, it reignites. Now, this is a 5th caster level item, so I think it's safe to assume that Burning Hands will do 5d4 of damage. A Grim Lantern will cost you 5,800 gold. The final wondrous item I'd like to talk about is the Necromancer's Athame. A necromancer who selects this item as their bonded object can use it to spontaneously convert any prepared wizard necromancy spell into any other wizard necromancy spell that you know. It must, however, be the same spell level or lower. A Necromancer's Athame will cost you 20,000 gold. The final item I'd like to go over with you is a spellbook. There are a number of unique spellbooks out there, and these spellbooks have interesting boons associated with them. In order to get this boon, you have to prepare at least 3 spells out of the spellbook. This will last until you actually expend the boon, or you prepare spells again. The book that I'm going to recommend is the Book of the Grave. The boon that the Book of the Grave gives you is Breath of the Grave. As a swift action, you can expel a 15-foot cone of rotting stench. Creatures within this cone must succeed a fortitude save of DC 10 plus your highest caster level, or be sickened for 1 round. After this boon is spent, you take a -4 penalty on diplomacy and stealth checks until you prepare spells again, because of the dark powers of halitosis. One final point on the Book of the Grave. One of the spells listed, called Vitriol, isn't actually a thing. I was not able to find it anywhere on the internet or in any of the Pathfinder books. So just be aware that spell isn't a thing. The final thing I'd like to say about this and just any wondrous items that I ever mention, it is possible to craft them yourself for half price if you have the skills. Now, if you're interested in more character builds and class analysis for Pathfinder or Dungeons & Dragons, check out D6damage right here on YouTube. Thank you for watching.